Senator Whitehouse.
Thank you. Ms. Yates, let me ask you a couple of, I think, pretty simple questions, if you could hear me out here. The first is that the sort of origin story here is a telephone call between Ambassador Kislyak and General Flynn. You became aware of that in the course of regular counterintelligence activities, correct?
That's correct.
Were you surveilling General Flynn, or were you surveilling Ambassador Kislyak?
I can tell you what we were doing, and that is surveilling General Flynn. I'm still not permitted to tell you what we were doing. That's still classified. Much as I would like to tell you, I can't.
Gotcha. So we'll just let logic follow through. It would not be unusual for a sovereign nation to monitor the communications of a rival nation's ambassador, irrespective of which nation you're in, correct? That's pretty standard counterintelligence practice.
If you don't mind, Senator, I'm just not going to hint at that. I want to stay really clear on the classification rules.
But you're being really clear that you are not surveilling General Flynn.
Absolutely not.
So the next thing you know of this conversation because you've overheard it. And the White House, at very high levels, including the Vice President, is denying that that conversation took place. The conversation that you knew happened. What is the counterintelligence problem with that set of circumstances? A national security advisor who has had a conversation with a Russian ambassador that the Vice President is denying took place.
Well, there's a counterintelligence concern about the conversations to begin with, given the fact that he was undercutting sanctions against the Russians for interfering in our election.
Is it a counterintelligence problem if the Russians, does it raise the prospect that General Flynn had lied to the Vice President and that the Russian ambassador would know that and be able to exert leverage on the National Security Advisor?
Exactly, Senator. And I said, you layer on top of that he has been lying.
There's a larger policy question around it, but there's a very specific issue right there, correct?
That's correct.
And it gives the Russians leverage against Mr. Flynn, possibly. General Flynn.
That was our concern, is that
that's the counterintelligence concern.
Potential conflicts. Yes.
So let me take you to a different question. You have been asked that if you knew of the errors and omissions that the Inspector General found in the FISA warrants, would you sign the warrant? And I think the answer that every prosecutor, myself included, must give to that question is no. Of course, we would never submit to a court a warrant application that we knew contained errors or omissions. That is correct, is it not?
That's correct, Senator.
But that does not, to my mind, as somebody who's been in that situation, that does not end the inquiry. The question then is, if you had been aware of the errors and omissions in the FISA warrant, one response would be to shut down the investigation and roll it up. A second would be to find out why the hell the errors and omissions were there, investigate the misconduct that led to that, but go ahead with the investigation because it remained predicated and worth pursuing. Both of those are possible options, are they not?
They are.
I'm sorry?
Yes, they are. Both are possible options.
And in fact, if we were in a situation in which any error or omission in a warrant affidavit ended the underlying investigation, a lot of criminal conduct and legitimate investigations would be improperly brought to a premature conclusion, correct?
That's true.
I'm sorry, say it again. We were not.
Yes, I'm sorry. That's true.
And that's pretty standard Prosecutor 101. If there's something that you think might be wrong with a warrant that you're being asked to sign, you get that fixed, but you don't necessarily end the investigation, correct?
Right, and you need to find out whether there is other evidence and other information that would support the But you would also want to get to the bottom of why it was you hadn't been told.
No, correct. You do an internal investigation to try to get to the bottom of why you were presented a warrant application with errors and omissions. But my point is a very simple one. That does not mean the end of the investigation necessarily. In fact, this is not necessarily uncommon. You solve your problem and you go ahead with your investigation if it's properly predicated and justified, correct?
That's correct.
Thank you.
And on a stroke of bipartisanship, I agree with everything you just said. That's exactly the way it should work. And I want to let Ms. Yates know that I have no doubt that when she signed the application, she did so in good faith, relying on information to be truthful, and that she would not have defrauded the court, and I have no belief that she did.